Hello everyone, and welcome to a special double episode of the Fall of the Mall, where we'll be taking a look at two malls in different states that both opened in March 1972. First up is the Northgate Mall in Hixson, Tennessee, which is a suburb of Chattanooga. Built by the predecessor to CBL Properties, Arlen Shopping Center Group, Northgate Mall opened as a competitor to the Eastgate Mall. Eastgate is no longer a mall, and now houses mostly offices. Episode 7 of the Fall of the Mall takes a tour through what Eastgate looks like presently. Northgate opened as the first enclosed mall in the Chattanooga area and had Sears, JCPenney, and Miller's as anchors. The Miller's anchor has gone through many changes as it became a Hess's, then a Profit's, and finally in 2006 became what is now a Belk. The mall underwent an expansion and a renovation in 1991, which added a food court and Profit's home store where a J.C. Murphy was previously. The mall was sold to General Growth Properties in 2000, and then CBL Properties reacquired the mall in 2011. In 2013, CBL did a major renovation to the mall, to the inside and outside, and added a new Old Navy store as well. This renovation removed most of the mall's plants and fountains, along with the raised center court stage area. In 2014, the space that occupied the food court wing, the Piccadilly restaurant, and the Belk home store was demolished, and in its place a 63,000 square foot Burlington store was built. Also in 2014, JCPenney announced they would be closing their store at Northgate Mall. In early 2019, Sears closed their location at the mall, leaving just Belk and Burlington as anchors. A lot of inline tenants have left the mall in recent years, with nearby Hamilton Place Mall providing a lot of competition to Northgate. Coincidentally, Hamilton Place is also owned by CBL Properties. Northgate Mall is currently 823,000 square feet, and Hamilton Place is over 1.3 million square feet. With two empty anchors, a large amount of inline tenants empty, and no food court, Northgate is struggling and will need help to stay relevant. If you know anything about this mall, leave it in the comments below. Next, we are taking a walk through the Anderson Mall in Anderson, South Carolina, With this mall also opening in March 1972 and also located in a small to mid-sized city, there are a lot of similarities between these two malls. Anderson Mall originally opened with JCPenney, Myers Arnold, and J.C. Murphy as anchor stores. In 1982, an expansion to the mall was announced. The J.C. Murphy store would be demolished, and the mall would extend out with two new wings from there. In 1984, this large expansion to the mall was opened, which doubled its size and added two new anchors as a Belk and a Sears were added, along with a food court. The Myers Arnold became an Upton's for a brief time, and after that chain folded, it became a second Belk store for men's and home departments. In 2007, the Belk men's and home department store closed. The men's department was moved back into the main Belk store, and the home department was moved to a large storefront adjacent to the main Belk store. This was to make way for a new Dillard's location, which opened in 2008. Also around that same time, the mall was renovated inside. Simon, who owned the mall, announced in 2014 they would be spinning off a select group of their malls, including Anderson Mall, into a new company called Washington Prime Group. In September 2018, Sears closed their location at the mall. That leaves JCPenney, which opened with the mall, Belk, which opened with the mall's expansion, and Dillard's, which was added in 2008, as the remaining anchor stores. The mall is currently 670,000 square feet. It is like the Northgate Mall, with several inline vacancies appearing in recent years, with the most occurring along the former Sears corridor. The mall has seen an increase in crime in recent years as well, with several large fights occurring at the mall in January 2017, and then in June 2018 a shooting occurred inside the mall, wounding a man, which was caught on cell phone video. Anderson Mall is showing signs of dying, even though it is only mall in the Anderson area, with Clemson University only about 20 minutes away. I had a hard time finding much other history or information on Anderson Mall online. If you know any history of the mall, leave it in the comments below. As always, if you haven't already, please be sure to subscribe to our channel, and that you've hit the bell notification icon so you can always get notified of our new videos. Thumbs up this video if you enjoyed watching it. Enjoy the rest of the video and see you on the next episode.